Hey, what's going on, friends? It's Dubs here, and welcome to Destiny. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video, and this is Destiny, for everybody wondering. It's really, really cool. I decided to get it after all. I looked up a bunch of videos and reviews and stuff like that, and streams even, just so I could see whatever this game is about and what it's like. This is my character right now, the weapons that he has and the armor that he has on. I will discuss that in a second. But basically, this little world that we're here on, it's basically just sort of, it's not even a moon. It's just the tower. I don't know how, what you'd call this, but it's just above the Earth. So you'll see now in a second when I go into the orbit, and you'll see exactly where this is sort of placed. This is, again, very futuristic, so it's really, really far into the future. I don't know exactly how far, but it is far into the future, and there you go. It's a little tower just above the Earth. And then if you go onto the Earth, it's all just taken over by aliens and stuff. So I'm not going to show you guys any of the actual missions that you have to do, like any of the story mode. Also, I don't have online yet or gold for Xbox, because I'm playing this on Xbox. I don't have gold yet because I've been trying to see what I can do with Microsoft. I've been messaging them and stuff, and I'm just waiting for a reply back on some stuff before I actually buy gold. But yeah, this is Destiny. It's absolutely beautiful. And that is a ghost. That little square thing, that's a ghost. Basically, he shows you where the missions are, or he shows you the location of where you have to go next. And also, he's sort of like your friend. He's, you know, you're sort of in need of him the majority of the time when you're doing these story missions. But again, this isn't actually single player. I was about to call it single player, but it's not really actually single player. You can actually play with other people in co-op. I don't know, I think to play with your actual friends, I think you do need gold, but you play with random people, like you're gonna see in a while, just a little bit later on, you're gonna see a dude just randomly riding off, and that's just an actual person. And as well, in the tower, you probably saw some other people just walking around, and those are all actual people, those are all players, you know, playing this game that were in that certain lobby. But yeah, so in this little mission thing that you have to do here, basically there's a bunch of missions just scattered around, and you sort of have to go around and you do your missions and you get XP from them. That's pretty much the whole deal with this with these set of missions. Of course, you're gonna get XP from the actual story missions as well, or from the campaign mode. But this is sort of like a little extra thing when you want to, if you want to like grind out or anything. So what I mean by grind out is your character will go up in levels, which will allow him to go ahead and get some better armor or better guns. And armor, of course, makes you deal less damage, makes you take less damage, not deal less damage. Makes you take less damage, and then of course the better guns, you're gonna deal more damage to the enemies. And as you saw above those enemies, I think it was like they were just like level 2 enemies, so they were very, very easy to kill. That's why I was just messing around with them a little bit. Then you're gonna have, of course, the bosses and stuff like that, which are of course gonna be a higher level or a little bit harder to kill. But for the majority of the time when you're playing this game, it's really, I don't know, it's just the way you sort of have to play this game. It's just nothing like any other game. It isn't like Call of Duty, it isn't like Halo. Probably like the shooting physics and the movement and stuff like that, maybe it's a little bit similar to Halo, but if you do decide to get this game, don't treat it like Call of Duty, don't treat it like Halo, because it's definitely not the same. It's actually a little bit more similar to like Diablo, for example, where you have to actually go up levels. Even though you're following the story mode and whatever, you still have to go around just killing enemies and going up levels and improving your armor and gear and just stuff, you know. So basically treat this like an RPG. Treat this a little bit more like an RPG, and then you're gonna have a lot of fun. And I think this genre of gaming, like, I don't know what you'd call this, because it's like a mixture between RPGs and first person shooters, but it's working. I really, really like it. And look at me fail a jump here in a second. But I really, really like it. And I think that I needed a game like this to come out, just because I was sort of bored of the just typical shooters or the typical, games that usually come out. And something like this is just, you know, it just changed. It changed first person shooters. It just changed the whole thing. And I enjoy it quite a lot. So if it's a game for you, if you think it's a game for you, then by all means get it, because it's a wonderful game. It's really, really good. You know, if you think that the game isn't that great, or if you don't know what to think of the game, then I don't know, try to rent out the game, because I think it works if you just rent the game, play the campaign or something like that, and then you can bring it back. But, you know, if you actually do decide to go play in multiplayer and whatever, it's pretty much the same as Call of Duty and Halo, stuff like that. If you do go to play multiplayer, it's, you know, basically PvP. But yeah, that's it. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this video, and hopefully you guys have enjoyed Destiny. If you guys want to see more of Destiny, I will make sure to bring out more videos on it. But for now, that's about it. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys later. Goodbye.